Hey there, everybody. It's Mark at MGCPuzzles.com. I'm coming to you tonight with a fun, great little image here. It's the Martini Mermaid. So I hope you enjoy me making this video. I'm going to be cranking to some supposedly royalty-free music. Last time I did this a couple weeks ago, turned out two of the songs weren't royalty-free. So anyway, we're going to have some fun, listen to some tunes. I'm going to make some comments along the way. Hope you enjoy the video. So on with the reading glasses so I can see a little bit better when I'm cutting, and on with the music. So I already kind of cut into this puzzle a little bit here. And I'm just gonna make comments as I go along. Hopefully you guys are liking the sound here. I did get a new microphone delivered today, and I'm pretty stoked. Seems to be working really, really well. My Snowball was a good microphone, but this one I think is gonna work out a lot better, especially with the background music of my sound system down here in my shop, which is really what I like to work with. So fingers crossed, this is gonna turn out kinda nice. Doing a nice little color line cut there right along the leg part of the tail. I'm gonna come down here too and do a little bit more right here, right along the tail fin and the black background. This is gonna be a really nice puzzle when it comes to the creative cutting style. I have not been doing a lot of cutting in the last few days, so I'm a little bit on the rusty side, but I have a feeling it won't take me long to get right back into the groove. Almost too loud for me to hear myself. I know that I've tested this out, and believe it or not, this microphone's really good at picking up what I'm saying without... Oh, I'll put it in the right spot. Picks up on what I'm saying a lot better than picking up on the background noise. I don't even need to speak so loudly, so I gotta kinda get used to talking at a normal tone of voice, so I'm not yelling at you guys. And girls. Wonder if I can do this. Nope, need the glasses today. Hopefully that just adjusted everything for everybody. I had to crank up the brightness level a little bit here. I was actually cutting a little bit too dark. Oh, and I didn't start my YouTube or my Facebook Live, so let me go with Facebook Live. Gonna do a quick intro for them once that kicks in. Hey there, everybody. This is Mark at MGCPuzzles.com. I just started my Facebook Live broadcast while I was already recording my YouTube. So everybody on Facebook, you're live when you tune in here. I'll glance up from time to time to see if anybody's writing any comments or questions. And if you are, I'll answer them. Probably take a minute or two for anybody to kind of start chiming in over there on Facebook. And I'm going to see if I can kind of come in here and get a little creative with the scrolling here. For those of you that are new to my channel, finding this video for the very first time, my name is Mark, and I have been a hand-cut wooden jigsaw puzzle maker for 25 years. I've cut over 11,000 puzzles in those 25 years, and I have probably spent about 30,000 hours here on my scroll saw, which is quite a lot of time doing a particular thing in your life. Oop, there goes that piece. Got it. And this wood that I'm cutting, it's 1/4 inch thick, 5-ply birch wood from Finland, as in the country. And I'm using a 7/1000ths of an inch thick blade. And to give you an idea of how thin that is human hair is approximately 4/1000ths of an inch. So, and I already lost track of where I'm at. No comments over there on Facebook as of yet. This blade is feeling really quite nice. Once in a while you put a blade on your saw and it has a beautiful feel to it, and this is one of those blades. Check out that puzzle piece. How nice that is. And we're gonna come in one more time right here. We're gonna do a very similar little sweep. We'll come down real quick and glance up into the camera to look at you guys once in a blue moon. But most of the time I gotta look down here at the saw, so. You get to see me bebop to the music a little bit. I use Spotify to stream my music in the background here through a nice sound system. When I'm not making videos, I play more commonly known music. But YouTube really likes to ding me. For those of you on Facebook, just so you know, I'm actually making a YouTube video at the same time that I'm making your video. Except Facebook is live and YouTube will be uploaded after I'm done. Thank you. I don't know how well you guys are hearing the music in the background, but hopefully you can hear it enough to enjoy it a little bit without it being very annoying. Any comments, please leave them down below. I'd love to hear your feedback as to how you're liking the way this video is looking and sounding. And in case anybody's curious, during this whole crazy global shutdown that we're going through, I am very healthy and I have no issues here. I've been pretty much homebound for a little over 2 weeks now. I have only ventured out twice in that time. And very careful each time I went out, mostly just to get a few groceries and run some important errands. So I'm working 7 days a week for the most part, between 10 a.m. and 7 p.m., except maybe Sundays I'll work a shorter day. I guess it just will all depend on needs. I hope everybody out there that's listening to me is doing okay and staying as safe as possible. If you do get this thing, I hope your experience is a mild one. Today is Thursday, March the 26th of 2020. Beautiful sunny day today. I took my dog Luna out a little bit. We went around the yard. She went on scent, and I had her on leash at the time, and she was extremely intent on finding this scent that she picked up. So I actually ventured into the woods with her, and she was pulling me along quite mightily. And if anybody knows what a blue tick coonhound is like, especially one that's about 80 pounds in size, that's a lot of torque in those legs. So if I had something with wheels, I would have been doing 30 miles an hour in about two shakes of a lamb's tail. And it turns out we came across what it was that she was smelling. And needless to say, initially I freaked out because she came across a skunk. But sadly, the skunk was no longer alive for some reason. I don't know what caused its demise, but immediately had to pull my dog away from that and out of the woods, which was a little bit of a tug of war initially, but she finally agreed to give up on trying to smell it or check it out any further. But yeah, that was kind of startling all of a sudden to see her literally pounce on the carcass of a skunk. I was like, oh boy, we got problems, and I don't want to be wasting my tomato sauce on trying to de-stinkify. The kind of crazy thing was, I myself didn't smell the skunk at all. And she went on scent out of the thin air with her nose up in the air, probably a good 100 yards away from where this thing was. And even pulled me through some pricker bushes and thorns trying to get there. Fortunately, I'm wearing blue jeans, so not that big a deal. No major war wounds. This puzzle I'm making right now, this Mermaid Martini, it will be in my Etsy shop probably tomorrow. So if you're interested in this puzzle and you want to buy it, it's going to be ready-made and able to head out the door in a matter of literally, I don't know, probably the same day if you order it early in the day tomorrow, or whatever day you order it. Otherwise, in a day or two, if you order it later in the day. I do pre-printed labels and stick them on my boxes and then just literally drop them off very, very quickly and at the post office, and extremely low interaction risk there. So I'm liking that a lot. Should have done a figural here. I not really have enough room right now to do it, but in the next quarter puzzle I will. I heard some news today from a peer of mine that a friend and colleague of mine named Dan Williams is going to be on TV this weekend. I'm not specifically sure what show, but it's going to be one of these weekend TV shows, sort of like the Today Show of some sort. And apparently, reports are that the jigsaw puzzle fad has kicked into full swing during this pandemic that we're going through, and people really are enjoying doing jigsaw puzzles while they're cooped up at home. And this is kind of reminiscent of the Great Depression, when jigsaw puzzles also had a really big following. They originally started kind of their fad in 1908-1909, and during the Great Depression, a lot of unemployed architects and engineers and even seamstresses, who are very good with using a sewing machine, if you can sew well, then you can probably make a halfway decent puzzle. And they were making puzzles during the week, and then on weekends they would take them to the street corner or places where people would be congregating and preparation for going away for the weekend, and they'd sell them to people that wanted to take them to their vacation homes or their family homes to have a puzzle to do over the weekend. And this is a way that they survived during the Great Depression. And suddenly it seems like this might be kind of a repeating itself some 90 years later. I don't know how many hand-cut wooden puzzle makers are going to be coming out of this that are going to be brand new, but I can tell you that cardboard puzzles coming off the shelves in stores that are open are definitely going to be a bit more popular. And those of you out there that do appreciate hand-cut puzzles and don't mind spending the extra money to commission me or some other hand-cut wooden puzzle maker to make one, this would be a really nice time to give your family a lovely treat. Support a starving artist, so to speak, since I made a video earlier today and then briefly mentioned in that video that a lot of my corporate business has completely gone away right now with the cancellations of all the various trade shows and major corporate meetings and gatherings of people and icebreaker and teamwork training kind of puzzles. They've all been put on hold or canceled. All of the potential orders that I was looking to make over the, already by now I would have been working on several of them between probably 2 weeks ago and all the way into early May. So it's definitely an unfortunate situation, but it is what it is, and got to make the best of it. I did just institute a special and extremely rare discount plan for my puzzles on my website. So if you go to mgcpuzzles.com and you right there on the top of the homepage, you'll see a reference to the whole coronavirus thing and the fact that I have created the discount page. So there's very specific parameters, but I'm giving some pretty sizable discounts between 15% and 30% off. And if you go there, you'll be able to do a little reading about it if you click on the link. I don't know how long I'm going to be offering this. This kind of a discount is kind of unprecedented for me. But in light of the situation and many people out there also being in a financial hardship, I think it's prudent to kind of like join together and you guys keep me busy and save some money, and I save your pocket some money in acquiring some really beautiful puzzles for your family to enjoy for many, many years to come. If you know anybody who is really into puzzles, please send them a link to my video and my website. I have two websites. I have a really old-fashioned one that I made back in 1996. Of course, I've updated it plenty since then, but that's how long ago I started that site. And that site was mgcpuzzles.com. And then I started a new website about a year and 3 months ago called custom-made wooden jigsaw puzzles.com, and that site is very, very modern. All of the photography on that website is no more than about a year and a half old, and really kind of a really great site. It's not nearly as comprehensive as mgcpuzzles.com is, but it has enough information on it and lots of really good photography, if I may say so myself, seeing as I shot all the photos. Photography is sort of an additional talent that I have. I've been into taking photographs since I was in the sixth grade, and I joined the photo photography club. And back in those days, it was black and white film photography. And in the club, everybody in the club got a roll of just 12 exposures of black and white film, and then we got to shoot that for the week, and then we met once a week and we bring our roll of shot film into the dark room, and we would develop that, and after we look at the negatives with a loop, we would pick two or three of the photographs we liked the best, and we would then print those, usually about 5x7 or 6x9 inch size, in the dark room with all of the various solutions. And I learned how to take a pretty decent picture through the course of that class. What to look for, how to frame up a photo, lighting, background, reflections. A lot goes into taking a nice photo. So anyway, I digress. I was mentioning custom-made woodenjigsawpuzzles.com, and I know that's a mouthful, but it's extremely descriptive of exactly what that website is all about. Hey there, Ron and Ira. Thanks for stopping in on Facebook there. Yeah, sorry about that. Kind of just got quiet, got in a little zone right here. Enjoying the saxophone. What do we want to do here? Hope you guys are liking the new microphone and the clarity that it's giving over top of the actually fairly loud background music. Even drowning out the saw a little bit, even though it's fairly close to the saw. I would say my mouth is only about 6 or 8 inches away from it, but the saw is about 10 or 12 inches away. And yet, in my test audio connection things there, I noticed that it was pretty quiet. Nothing too overwhelmingly noisy down there with the saw. Kind of coming along nice here. And now that I just thought about it, we're gonna stencil out a figural. So I don't know, what should we do in here? A mermaid and a fish. Could do an anchor. Here, peel off that saw and see what I've got here. Got a cool little crab there. Yeah, maybe do that. We'll put that aside. We got a nice little starfish there. We might consider that and an octopus. Got some geometric figures. Here we go. We got a couple of mermaids. We got one there. We got one here. Yeah, there's actually three of them. All right, let's keep that aside. That's a possibility. Now we got another cool crab right there. And we got a lobster. And we got a shark and another kind of lobster. Or we can put a young sailor in there. Falling in love with the mermaid. That could be interesting. And an accented shark right there with the gills. Yeah, I just realized the microphone's over here. Should have swung it over while I'm doing this with the figurals. Still getting used to doing these videos. All right, let's see here. Here we go, we got a swordfish. Need a signature piece in there, so we'll pull that one out. Yeah, we get a seagull, but I don't know, not below the water, so we'll pass on that one right now. All right, I think that's good for now. All right, let's get back to doing some cutting here. Bring the microphone back over to my saw. And we'll stencil out a figural here. About to figure out what we're gonna choose. All right, so the orientation is like such. I like the sailor guys, so let's do the sailor. Get myself a pencil. And we're gonna stick him on there. All right. So let's carve out this this young sailor here. Kind of easy. Always come in a pointy spot in the figure whenever I approach one. I'm gonna stick that aside. I'm gonna come back in and carve that here in a moment. Just gonna take this tape off and exit the piece that I'm cutting right now. Let's come in here and give this thing a couple of accents. See what that looks like. Not bad. Where'd that one come from? There we go. Color line cut kind of even tricked me. I think this is turning out turning out pretty nice over here. I'm liking this puzzle. Hopefully you're enjoying watching me cutting it. It is definitely going to be a tricky little bugger. Somebody out there one of these days is going to be the proud owner of it. And hopefully it'll be you. I'm going to do one of my little tricks, and I did it on the other part too. I didn't really mention it as I'm doing it, but I'm coming right out of here and I'm splitting the corner. So you can't quite figure out that that's a corner piece. Whenever I make figurals, I do tend to give away the pieces that go around it kind of easily. Only that it's quick and easy to get those, but then you're right back into the challenging part of trying to figure out the rest of the puzzle. I had a feeling that blade was going soon. I could kind of feel that it was starting to get a little dull. See what happens when you push it to the limit, and it'll snap on you. That was a nice blade that we cut. Good, I want to say a good 60 puzzle pieces with that. Lasted a while. All right, well, back to the beginning of the playlist. Let's we'll hit that back up there. The end of that for now. So I'm gonna zoom in a little bit for you folks to just kind of get a glimpse of that. It turned out all right. So that's half the puzzle. That's all the time I'm gonna take for this video tonight. Don't want to bore some people too much, but hopefully you enjoyed watching the video and listen to my occasional commentary. And if you like the video, please give me a thumbs up down below. And subscribed if you haven't already. Thank you very much, and you guys have a wonderful and safe evening.